Do you have a repeatable process where maybe you receive a message in Slack, Microsoft Teams, or email, and you want to automatically create a task for someone on your team to tackle whatever is contained in that message? Well, if so, you are going to love this video because it's exactly what we're talking about: how to build this integration for task management in SmartSuite and integrating with a brand new tool not yet seen a lot until now, and I'm talking about Ply. So if learning how Ply and SmartSuite can help you with your task management and automation, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Today, we're talking about SmartSuite and Ply, two of my favorite no-code tools and very cutting edge. Now, what I'm about to show you here in this particular training is unique to these two tools. I am managing tasks inside of SmartSuite, and there are certain features inside of SmartSuite that are going to make this much more enjoyable, a much more pleasurable experience, and you're going to see those as soon as we kick into this automation. Now, I'm also talking about Ply. Ply is a relatively new automation tool. They are currently in beta. In fact, they're so new that they don't even have a revenue model yet. They are still just testing. So if you want to get access to what you're seeing here today, you'll have to sign up for Ply's beta. They are letting people in as we speak. So make sure to go ahead and sign up for that. I'll include links below this video. Also for SmartSuite, if you're not already a SmartSuite user, you're definitely gonna want to be one when you see what we build here today. All right, enough on that. Let's go ahead and hop into the heart of this video. We are going to be building an automation that takes some sort of notification. In our example, we're gonna say we received an email and we wanna be able to automatically create a task for someone on our team and additionally add some context. So maybe we want to put in some special instructions, maybe we want to assign a due date to that. This is all going to be possible by just the push of a button when all is said and done here. So in order to get started, I have us set up first with an email example. So in this case, I emailed myself and I said, "Hey Gareth, please take this sample message into consideration, create a task for someone on your team, thanks." Okay, so any message will do, but we actually want to leverage the context of this message in our automation. Now, the other thing is, we don't want to actually leave Gmail in this case, or maybe you're a Microsoft 365 user. I don't want to leave the environment that I'm working in. I want to be able to create this task just by pushing a button. I don't want to get distracted. So that's going to be available thanks to Ply. But before I move on, I also have to share with you our setup inside of SmartSuite. So in SmartSuite, I have an application here called Tasks. My solution is Task Management. And you can see that I'm creating tasks, in many cases, assigning due dates, assigning a priority and a status. We have a few different status here: backlog, in process, ready for review and complete. And we have some extra context here. We have the task itself. We have a description, you know, who it's assigned to and all the other pertinent information. Now, the reason that I love SmartSuite for task management is because of this little place called My Work. Up here in My Work, I see all of the tasks assigned to me across everything in SmartSuite. It doesn't matter if it's in the specific solution that I'm working in, task management, or if it's somewhere else. Here's applied test solution, here's a new solution, here's my contacts. I have tasks assigned to me in a number of different places, but all of those tasks are consolidated here in My Work, and this is why, in my humble opinion, SmartSuite is the leader for task management inside of no-code. So now that we understand the basic setup, let's get into building this automation using Ply. I'm gonna head back into whatever I wanna use as a trigger. In our case, it is this specific email. And in the browser here, if you look up to the top, I've already granted access to Ply through a Chrome extension. So I'm going to left click here, and it will allow me to create what they call an add-on. And I can assign this add-on to my Gmail workspace. So I'm gonna create it. And on the next screen here, once it's taken a moment to think, it's gonna ask me what account I wanna connect to. If I haven't already connected my account, just as you would with Zapier or make.com, it's fairly straightforward to get set up. You just have to build the integration between Ply and the tool that you're using. So follow the on-screen instructions for connecting your account or select a connected account right here. It'll take a moment and we move on to the next step. Now, we have a few different places that we can add elements. And elements are essentially buttons or triggers that we're going to add into our software using our browser. Now that sounds too good to be true if you've never seen Ply in action, but if you stick with me, you're gonna see exactly how this goes. So I've got a few different options here, but what I'm looking for is to add a button inside of my message. I've already opened up a specific email message. That's where I want to add my button so that I can take the context of that message and shoot it on over into the task that I'm going to create in SmartSuite. So let's make that selection here. And now it's going to say, go to a message, click the indicator, and that's going to allow you to create a button. So check this out. I say, okay, because I'm already in a message inside of my Gmail. Well, there it is. That blinking little icon right there is where Ply wants me to click to create my own button. I'm going to go ahead and do that. And now it's going to open up and say, design your button. So I can pick from a long list of different icons right here. Let me go ahead and find something like this one here. Looks pretty good. I can add a tooltip to it. I can say something like create task. In case I forget what that button does, when I hover over it, it's going to now show me that tooltip. I can also pick a color. For our example, I'll stick with this nice blue here that was preloaded for me. And once I'm happy with the design of my button, both the icon, the color, and the tooltip, I can move on and open up the builder. So now what's happening is it's going to tell me when somebody pushes that button, that's what's going to initiate this workflow or automation. And the very next thing that Ply is going to do is grab the contextual message of the button that we pushed inside of that email. So if you recall, I pushed the button inside of a message. So now Ply is going to find out what that message is so that I can use it in the next steps. Next, what I want to do is have some sort of interactive component with my automation where I can now enter in some extra data. Maybe, for example, I want to pick who on my team is going to have this task assigned to them. Maybe I also want to assign a due date. Maybe I also want to provide some extra context around what this task is. I can do all of this without ever leaving the screen that I'm on because Ply, as it runs through the steps of the automation, can present me with a little interactive window where I can provide additional context. But before we get to that, I want to actually make sure that I'm using people that already exist inside of my SmartSuite account. If I have an interactive window, I want to make sure that I'm giving people a list of users that are actively using SmartSuite. I don't want to pick somebody from a dropdown that's no longer on my team. So how can we do that? Well, next step here is going to be to click here to add another step, and I'm going to sync it up here with SmartSuite. If I don't see SmartSuite just dropped down here, I can start searching. It's one of the many different integrations that Ply has. And once I'm inside of here, I can see all of the different options that I have with SmartSuite. Here's where things get next level cool. The way SmartSuite is built, we can actually look up a list of the existing users inside of our SmartSuite system. So some of these are fairly straightforward, right? Uploading a file or creating a record or updating a record. Well, yes, we can do those things in most automation tools, but have you ever seen the capability of listing out users inside of your account? So basically, the advantage here is as I onboard new people to SmartSuite, they are automatically going to be found when I run my automation. As I get rid of people on my team, if they are terminated or leave, well, then I remove them from SmartSuite and they're no longer going to be returned in this list. So here it is. I'm going to list out my users in SmartSuite. Of course, I have to choose my account or connect a new one if I haven't already done so. And let's go ahead and continue here. Now, the next piece is going to be to test this step. We see that there is not a checkbox here, meaning that this step has not yet been performed satisfactorily. So I'm going to say test step. And this is going to then search my SmartSuite account and bring back a list of users. And if we look here, we can see that I'm the first one back. My name, Gareth, right here, my job title, my company name, all of that information. But I want to point out that the thing that matters the most is this ID right here. Because this is the ID that SmartSuite has assigned to me as a user. And when I'm talking to SmartSuite later to assign a task to a user, I have to make sure that I'm using SmartSuite language and that I'm referring to a user the way SmartSuite thinks about them, which means that I need to know that ID. So that's the value that I need to pull back, or whatever ID is associated with any different user, if I want to link to them properly. But you'll see here that I've got 18 different users in my SmartSuite account. I can cycle through and see all the different folks because that whole list, that table of users, was pulled back for me in this step. So now that I have a list of users, let's leverage that list of live users in our next step, where we build a little bit of an interface that's gonna show up when we push that button. So right here, we're gonna add yet another step. And here, I'm gonna pop in that little interface. Add a custom user-facing step. This way, I'm building a slightly interactive engagement with this automation. It's not just push a button and forget about it. It's push a button and provide a little bit more context within this interface. So first, I'll name the interface. I'll say add task context. And now I can add blocks to the interface. So the first thing I'll do is ask for the name of this task. So I'll put in a text input and I'll say something like task name. And I can make this required, of course. So that way you can't move on to the next step within the automated process until you've filled it out. Now, additionally, I want to bring in the user information. So if we scroll on down, I have the option of putting in a dropdown. And this is exactly what I want. I want people to pick a user from the dropdown list. I will rename this label here and call this pick an assignee. And here in the options is where I'm gonna sync up with the table of users in the previous step. So I'm gonna switch over here to a table. And this of course means that, as I mentioned earlier, when we onboard or offboard new members to SmartSuite, the automation is going to know that every time. So here I'm gonna sync this with my source of data, which is my list of users, and I'm gonna select them right here. However, what do I want people to see when they hit the dropdown right here? I haven't chosen a column yet, so I have to assign a column here. What I'm looking for is the full name, or as SmartSuite has identified it, the system root. So I can scroll on down here, and I should be able to find the system root. Here it is, full name. I'll just pop that in right here. And now if I look on clicking my dropdown, we're gonna see a list of names. These are the different users inside my SmartSuite account. But wait, I don't want the username to be used in the next step. I need the user ID. That's how SmartSuite thinks about these users. That's the information I need to give my SmartSuite account in my next step when I create the task. So I can switch on to what is called option value mode, which means that we're gonna see the full names as an option to select in the dropdown, but the value that we're gonna collect from that is actually gonna be the ID. If you recall, the ID is what identifies every user in SmartSuite. So now that I have that, maybe I'm gonna add one more step here, which is gonna be a date picker. This is going to allow me to assign a due date inside of my automation. So I'll just bring that in here. And let's make it required again, just as we should have done back here for the assignee. Let's make that required. Now we have to run and create sample data at every step. So let's do that. Once I click here, I'll put a task name in. This is going to be sample task. And my assignee, I'll pick on myself. And then a due date, I will pick it a week from today. Today is July 5th. A week from today, July 12th. Now I'll click done. And this is gonna show us what data we collected. So you'll see that the date came through, the task came through, but most importantly, the ID of the user in SmartSuite came through. All right, now we're almost done. The last step is to actually build the task inside of SmartSuite. So let's do it. I'm gonna pop in here, add one more step, pull up SmartSuite again, and we are going to create a record. Now, my particular account, of course, is already connected. We have already used it in a previous step. Once I move on from here, we're going to be asked what solution. Mine is called task management. So here it is. I can find it just like that. And I pick the application as well. I'm looking at my tasks application. And once we're good here, it's gonna ask us to map some data to this particular record that we're creating. So what's the description? Here, my friend, is where we can bring in the context of the message. So I can pop in here and use the actual email that I started this whole automation with and just pop it into the description of this task. Who am I assigning it to? Here's where I want to map data. I want to map to the fourth step because I got the ID of the user in that step. What's the status? Well, of course, this is a brand new task, so I'll assign it to backlog. What's the due date? We got that in the fourth step as well. Let's pop that due date in. Maybe I don't have a priority. Maybe I don't want to add anything else other than the task name itself, which we provided again in our little interactive task creator here. So now I've mapped everything that I need. Let me go ahead and test this step, and I'm going to fly back into my SmartSuite account and scroll on down to see this task now created. So here it is. It's been assigned to me. It's taking the body of that email. If you recall, this was the thing that started the whole automation. And then here is the task name that we created, and of course the due date as well. And we see that this has been added to backlog. So now that we're done with this, let's flip back into Ply and let's publish our brand new automated workflow and give it a true test. I'm gonna flip back into my Google account now. You can see we've got our new button created. This is going to exist anywhere that we open up our Gmail and look inside of a message. So if I wanted to trigger off of this message again, I can simply click that button right here. And in the bottom left corner, we see that Ply is going through the automation step by step. We can even track what it's doing. Got a message by ID, listed out the users, and now we're at the interface step. So here we are. Let's say I want to name this task test. I'm going to assign this one to Eric, and I'm going to pick a due date of July 31st. When I click done, that should then take us through the last piece of the automation. We see we created that record in SmartSuite. I'll flip back into SmartSuite and look at Eric's tasks. And here it is, task test. Again, we grabbed the context of that email. It was assigned to Eric for July 31st, put into backlog. This is incredibly powerful. We just added an automation button that looks like it's a native part of our Gmail account, and it's gonna live there and allow us to run this automation whenever we want. I know we went pretty fast in this video because there's a lot to unpack, but if you have any questions, please feel free to drop them below wherever you found this. And in the meantime, keep on building.